The Windrush Project, we're celebrating from the time that the people from the Caribbean have come over here. Britain called, we answered.
It is absolutely fantastic news that the National Museum of Wales has embraced this project, because this is the recognition of Black contribution, the contribution of people of Black, African, African Caribbean, Asian, and minority ethnic communities to Wales.
Mae'r arddangosfa yn benllanw prosiect hanes llafar wedi arwain gan Gyngor Hil Cymru a'i ariannu gan Gronfa Treftadaeth y Lotri.
To celebrate the people who come over from the West Indies. The Windrush, that ship, the first ship, apparently came in 1948.
It jumped at the opportunity. They didn't leave as running away from the islands. They came because there was work to be done here. Britain was flattened, as you know, and you had all these ex-servicemen as well as nurses who wanted to run the hospitals, and well, all sorts of people, carpenters, you name it.
We came over and we rebuilt Britain.
Maen nhw'n gymysgedd o'r llon a'r lleddf, straeon ysbrydoledig am adael cartref, am greu aelwyd newydd yma yng Nghymru, dod o hyd i waith ac ati magu teulu o'r newydd.
When I came to Britain, I was 15 years old and I became a nurse at 17. And then I got married, had my family, and then after having my family, I joined the Territorial Army, 203 Welsh General Hospital in Llandaff North. And I served 25 years.
Yeah, my parents come here, they moved to Cardiff and they had the first Black Pentecostal church in Cardiff.
Maen nhw'n straeon cignoeth ac emosiynol iawn hefyd sydd yn datgelu gwirioneddau caled am ein cymdeithas ni.
The other side of Windrush is that when you came over, whatever you expected, it wasn't what you know you were told. You know, you'd be looked after. And that wasn't the case, you know. People turn their back on you, as I always say, because you weren't white British.
It was part of the dream of so many elders. I'm thinking about Mrs. Betty Campbell, who was one of the Black, the first Black headmistress to be in Wales, to be appointed in Wales, and to work and live and serve in Wales. And she said to me at a Black History meeting, our stories are so precious. The experiences of our journeys and the journeys of our family members to this country to help rebuild Britain is so rich, but nobody, hardly anybody knows it. Wouldn't it be so important that we capture it before many of us die?
It's good now that people know that we were invited to come here. And they even paid some people fares. They gave the government, you know, whoever was running the country, administrator or the governor general, to help people and to come here.
This is a good thing because people didn't understand what happened to the Windrush. All the people who came over on the Windrush, people didn't understand. So now that we've put a face to everything and it's going into the museum, people understand. And it's very good that it's going to the school.
And I think it's a celebration of a lot of the contributions. I mean, and their children now, you know, their descendants now, what they've done and how they've embraced, you know, living here and the education as well.
O beth sy'n wych ydy bod yr hanesion llafar, sef sylfaen yr arddangosfa, yn dod i'r archif yma yn Seifagan, ac felly y dod yn gofnod parhaol o ddylanwad aruthrol cenhedlaeth y Windrush ar ein hanes ni fel cenedl.
So I'm hoping that everybody around Wales will come and walk in and hear the stories of sacrifice, of pain, of suffering, but of joy and of travailing and of achievement and power and passion. And I know that we can never be forgotten or written outside or written away from the history of Wales. We matter.
Windrush to me means, you know, people who come over here and made a difference, but helped.
Mae'r sioe yn agor yma am fis, a wedyn mi fydd hi'n teithio i rai o leoliadau eraill Amgueddfa Cymru drwy gydol y flwyddyn ac i fewn i flwyddyn nesaf.
So I think beautifully that the museum has to be the repository. It is the natural place that we all want to go to learn about the history of Wales. So what an honor to have the stories of our elders archived there and displayed there as we open the exhibition.